The panic over coronavirus is in full swing this week. If you guys have been to a grocery store or a CVS over the past week, you know that it's hard to get toilet paper, food, water, basic necessities. We just found out that Tom Hanks and his wife have been diagnosed with coronavirus. The NCAA just canceled their March Madness basketball tournament. The NHL, NBA have both canceled their upcoming seasons or the rest of their seasons. MLB is delaying opening day, which is devastating for baseball fans like me. But through the midst of all of this, the media is still trying to politicize this virus. One of the biggest claims that they have made over the past week, for example, is that if you refer to the coronavirus or COVID-19 as the Wuhan virus or the Chinese coronavirus, then guess what? You are a racist. It is no longer appropriate, according to the media, to refer to a virus from its place of origin, which we know that the coronavirus originated in Wuhan, China. Never mind the fact that tons of viruses and diseases are named after their place of origin, whether it's Ebola being named after a river, the Spanish influenza, Lyme disease, the list goes on and on. But apparently this only counts that you're a racist if you're talking about China, because the media has this weird, bizarre thing they like to do where they like to shill on behalf of the Chinese Communist Party and spread their propaganda. So Chris Hayes, who is an MSNBC anchor on primetime, tweeted this week, "Just astoundingly gross to call it the Wuhan virus. Not quite as gross as eating bat soup, but I digress." David Gura, who is also an MSNBC reporter, said, "FYI, calling COVID-19 the Wuhan virus is racist." What the media apparently forgot, though, is that they all were calling it the Wuhan virus or Chinese virus, coronavirus, just last week. In fact, there is a nice compilation video of them doing exactly that.
At least six people have died from the Wuhan coronavirus.
The Wuhan coronavirus has now surpassed the 2003 SARS outbreak in the number of lives it's claimed.
They're under quarantine out of concern that passengers and crew were exposed to the Wuhan coronavirus.
And this breaking news just into CNN, the official death toll from the Wuhan coronavirus in China's Hubei province has now risen to 780.
Having to deal with it, the total number of deaths from the Wuhan coronavirus, it's now surpassed the SARS outbreak from 2003.
This other nutty woman, who's a staff writer at The Atlantic and Applebaum, suggested that the U.S. is not a superpower because of the way that they've responded to the coronavirus, tweeting, quote, "China has reacted to the outbreak of coronavirus in Italy by sending aid. The U.S. has reacted by suspending flights. Who is the superpower?" Stunningly bad take. It's actually crazy to watch the media shill for China, just like the NBA did back in the fall when they were locking people up in concentration camps. But this is nothing new, because the media will side with whoever makes Trump or the United States look bad. And in this case, China is obviously livid that the outbreak of this virus is being blamed on them, despite the fact that that's where it originated. And so they're trying to push the blame back onto the United States and, by proxy, President Donald Trump. Well, the media is more than happy to let Trump take the blame for all of this, because it will lower his chances of being reelected come November in this 2020 presidential election. So expect to see more of this politicization of the virus and trying to make Trump the person who's responsible for all of it. For everyone who is worried about coronavirus, by the way, I want to give you guys some helpful tips before I sign off. These are directly from the Center for Disease Control, so you know that this is the real deal. Of course, they say that you should wash your hands often. This means with warm soap and water, hand sanitizer if you have to, but warm soap and water is better. According to the CDC, avoid close contact with other people. And if you're sick, you should stay home unless you need to go out to get medical care. And you should call ahead to your doctor so that if they do suspect that you have coronavirus, they can be prepared to administer a test for you. An important note on those face masks that you see all around the big cities right now: if you are sick, you should be wearing a face mask because it can prevent the transmission to other people. But if you're not sick, save your money. Don't worry about buying one of these on Amazon, because it won't prevent you from getting infected with the virus if you are coming in contact with someone who has it. So make sure that you guys stay safe. I know that I'm planning to stay home in my apartment for most of the weekend, if not well into next week, until we see really the spread of this virus in the United States, just taking as many precautions as possible to make sure that this doesn't turn into the major outbreak that everyone is expecting. So stay safe, y'all. Hey guys, you're watching Unfit to Print. If you'd like to watch the full episode, click the link down below. Again, don't forget to subscribe to the Daily Caller's YouTube channel and hit that notification bell and search for Unfit to Print on iTunes and SoundCloud.